Yep, thank you, Kilo. We are sorry. Also, if you can hear, like, double music, we tried our best to, like, stop it, but so that both of us can see the picture. So that both of us can see the picture, we have it plugged into the TV, so yeah. Please ignore if you can kinda hear double, thing. Also, hi, Stratori, hello! Yeah, that's Peachy. Yeah, I'm here with Shrimp Sis, as you can probably tell. We were going to play Rayman, but then the site we got it from decided to not be controller compatible and a bitch, so we can't do it. I miss you. Paper Woomy! Oh!
I'm sorry, I barely come.
No, that is alright. I'm happy to see you. Hello, how have you been? We're over here doing
things.
But yeah, I'm here with Shrimp Sis and we are over here struggling. I can tell you right now, it's probably not going to be too long of a stream since it's so late. We'll get through the prologue and that'll probably be it. We will be doing this again tomorrow, much earlier, so that we can get through some of chapter one, because unfortunately she has to work after tomorrow. But yeah, we tried. Hashtag we tried. This is basically the biggest Easter egg stream. Yeah. Honestly, yeah. We're over here like,
this is the latest truly, it truly is an Easter egg.
It's a true Easter egg, yeah. Anyway, let's bring the music back to this. I'm not sure if the Danganronpa music is, like, extremely copyrighted or whatnot, so let's just hope it's not. If that's the case, we're just gonna keep it, like, there, and the sound effects, like, there, and the voice, cool, the voices are high up.
Oh, dang it, Grandpa!
Dang it, Grandpa! Yeah, dang it, Grandpa!
Oh, animation, a paper will be more interested.
Yeah, we're playing Dang It Grandpa today. Hopefully no one will mind. Mostly it's gonna be Shrimp Sis, and I'm just gonna be here doing my thing. So, I will mostly be reading the chat. So, hello? Kind? You're going to Kind? What kind of person are you that you want to go to Kind?
You're not Kind as normal, damn it.
I know, but come on.
The shade decide then.
Animation. New shade is mom. Okay. New shade is a mama. Confirmed.
Kind or not?
Yeah, I don't know. Whatever you want. I'm just picking on you.
Oh. Normal it is.
I'm kind in logic, but mean in action. But yeah, tell me if you can't hear the game. I will make sure to fix it as much as I can. This is a pretty bonked stream already. So worry not. We're all bonked. And like, we love this game. We truly do. Oh goodness, this looks like my childhood time with my dad! Oh no! I hope not! I also like that the game is thankfully not lagging out the cutscenes. That's all I ask.
It shouldn't, since it's a gaming laptop.
It shouldn't, but you know, sometimes our computer can be extremely bitch.
The one with mine will be lagging. Not by much, but it will be lagging.
Wait, does it still say we're playing Rayman? Holy shit, why does it say we're still playing Rayman? Oh my god, we're on the wrong thing! This is all kinds of bonked!
It's past 12, we're drunk.
Ooh.
Oh, the text.
What? Fucking excuse me? Oh no, we can't read it, but they can? This is weird.
Wait, there. Wait, you're just...
It's fine on their end. It's not fine on our end. Oh shit. That gives me time to pull up the new screen. Hold on, we're gonna bring the game back up and see if we can actually read.
This is not going well at all.
Ooh, hold on. There's so much bonk already. Ooh, please stand by. Ba-doop-ba-doop-ba-doop as we fucking try to fix things. Oopsie whoopsie, looks like your game is bonked. Let's see. Yeah, please.
Spooky, scary skeletons. Like, Lord, I'm gonna cry.
Oh.
Spaces said right by for skeleton time.
Oh, turns out my computer is not 920 to 1080. Let's hope that this is better. Is this better? Oh, this is windowed mode. Extreme windowed mode. Oh no, no one wants this. This is not what we want as an audience. Hold on. Ugh.
It has options, so explore which one is good.
Full screen. Which one is mine?
Can you say freaking something?
I have to figure it out.
I wish I could date a skeleton. Because that way I won't stare at their chest hair. Oh, by the way, I was 7 in the morning, can't find my wallet, lol.
Who?
Paper Woomy.
Oh no, it's fine, Woomy. You don't have to. I'm just over here trying to fix the bonk. Oh. Let's see.
No, I must, says Woomy.
You must! No! You don't have to! 1080 to 1024? Let's hope that's okay. Is that correct? I don't know. Now it's not showing. What the fuck? Oh! We somehow broke the game in 12 different levels. This is why you don't allow me to set up anything.
Woomy said he must, so they must. This is the law of Mama.
Oh no.
Is that new shade?
You know what? We're probably gonna have to play in windowed mode and it's gonna look tiny. Ooh. There is nothing that I can do to make it better.
What about the first one, border or whatever?
Borderless does not show up on the capture, so we're gonna have to play this tiny mode.
Ew.
Yeah, it's ew, I know, I'm sorry. Listen.
Maybe it'll be big for them, and for us it's gonna be
Oh, game capture, what is going on here? hold on while we fix the game capture to actually look nice and not stupid. I feel like that's a bit too big, hold on.
This music is amazing, yes it is.
It honestly is! That's caps lock, no wonder it wasn't working. We're fixing it! It's fixed, we're not bonked! Cool, so long as you guys can see it and we can see it while we play, that's all that matters. Okay. Okay. Let's just hope that nothing bonks it any further than this. Ooh. And let's just also hope that this doesn't get me like copyright struck for no reason, because some games are weird with their copyright thing. I don't know, it's been coming back.
I don't know why.
Danganronpa has been coming back for some reason. Even though I haven't played any of these games, but it seems like a fun time. I might consider it for some summertime. Yeah, they're actually like really fun games. Like, don't let the fan base like scare you off of them. The fan base is,
Can you like them?
I can.
Or that will make it bad for them.
No, it shouldn't. Hold on.
If it makes it bad for them, then I'll put up with it.
Oh, that's not what I want.
Now my control isn't working.
Because I'm using the... Yeah, no, I can't make it any bigger than that. That's just how
it is
by default.
I mean the expansion on the tab.
No, I can't.
What? Ew.
We have to play like this.
No, not load.
New game. We're starting a new game.
I forgot.
At this point, no fan base can scare me. Well, that's a good thing. Okay, we're starting over. And this time, let's hope that we can actually read the fucking dialogue, since our couch is blocking half of it. Smile. Ooh. Bonk streams are my favorite. How are you feeling, Shrimp Sis? I'm sorry. I got 2 new ferrets! Oh my gosh! You need to share them in the Discord at some point in time. Cause I want to see the babies. Hey, just like my dad used to tie me up. What? Sir, are you okay? Are you okay, sir? Do we need to speak? Yo, I wanna see ferrets. We all wanna see ferrets. But yeah, we're upset and Rayman 2 is on our bad side at the moment, so no Rayman. I meant how I used to tie him up. That's not any better. Yoshi, what the fuck?
It's okay, he's so silly, he's tired.
Okay, let's do this.
Let's actually play this without fucking everything up.
And then the text still doesn't.
And then the text is still tiny, next thing you know. No, there we go. Who's gonna be the narrator and who's gonna do what?
You're gonna be the narrator.
The massive high school towers over all the other buildings in this bustling urban area. It's like the school stands at the center of the entire world. Chad narration. I meant how I tied my tie, fixed it. Hope's Peak Academy. It brings in top students from every field imaginable, a government-funded school of privilege. They say that if you come here and manage to graduate, you'll be set for life. With hundreds of years of tradition, it sends the cream of the crop into the workforce every year. You must voice act, it's the Danganronpa Law. Okay, we need to make voices. It was built to raise hope in the nation's future, which makes Hope's Peak a pretty fitting name. There are 2 things you need to attend this school. 1, you have to already be attending high school. 2, you have to be the very best at what you do. No ordinary student could enroll here. The only way in is if you're scouted by the school itself. And standing there at the gate of the ultimate school fills with the ultimate student. I wanted to add high school, but I realized that the word high was not in there.
You just went,
I imagined it. Ultimate school. I could enroll in as the best procrastinator. Oh my god. Was me. Oh god, I forgot that it was Makoto making the voice.
I guess I should introduce myself. My name's Makoto Naegi.
I sound less cooler when I'm not talking in my head. As you can see, I'm nothing but a hopelessly average high school student.
I don't know why, but I want you to make him sound depressed.
Oh, you want me to make him sound depressed? Okay, fine. Let me use my best depressed voice. As you can see, I'm nothing but a hopeless average high school student. Number 15, Burger King foot lettuce. Average on the outside, average on the inside. I really don't have much going for me when it comes to grades, special abilities, even personality.
Sigh.
I mean, yeah, I have hobbies and stuff I like to do, but it's not like I'm a psychic or mutant or whatever. Said Makoto with Burger King foot lettuce. The last thing you want in your Danganronpa gameplay is Burger King foot lettuce. Like, if you ask me what my favorite song was, or my favorite movie or TV show, they'd all just be whatever's most popular at that particular moment. Even among the average, I'm completely average, so I can't even say I'm your everyday hero type. Sigh. Ew, I hate this guy! That's just who I am! Anyway, I figure it's always good to introduce yourself right off the bat. But you know, if I have any kind of strong point, so to speak, I'd say I'm a little more gung-ho than other people. I mean, look at me. I'm completely ordinary, but still. Here I am, standing in the front of anything but ordinary's Hope's Peak Academy. I'm losing it, boys. I still can't believe I'm standing here. I wonder if someone like me can survive in a place like this. I bet this strong voice is being a simp! You said it! No, no, wait! Yeah, you're gonna get banned by Twitch! Okay. It's got this overwhelming presence, like it's trying to swallow me whole. That's kinda kinky. But it's no wonder I would feel that way. What you have to understand is... Don't get deleted. Well, let me just tell you about the preparation I did last night to get ready for today. My eye is stinging like hell.
Take a deep breath.
Connecticut.
You good?
Yeah. Hope Speak only invites those students who are truly elite in their field. It's such a popular topic. There are threads online dedicated to talking about the school's attendees. That's kind of weird, but okay. I bet you his favorite color is red. So to prepare, I looked up some of those threads. And all I saw was talk about ultimate students who were way beyond your average high schooler. For example, one incoming student is the ultimate pop sensation.
Hooray.
Hooray! I guess she's a high school girl who's also the lead singer for a pop group famous all over the country. Most likely the one kid who never gets picked in dodgeball probably eats fries with ketchup instead of cheese! There's also the ultimate baseball star. He was the cleanup hitter for the National High School Champs. Pro teams already have their eyes on him.
What a dog.
What a hunk. He's bald, lol. Then there's the ultimate fashionista. Oh my god, girl. When you bald so hard, your hair falls. She's been on the cover of tons of fashion magazines. She's what every high school girl wants to be. Oh, and they mentioned the ultimate biker gang leader too. Why would they allow this? The scary thing is, he's the de facto leader of every biker gang in Japan. Gangs everywhere love the guy. Why are we letting this guy into our school? I feel attacked. Every high school girl wants to be objectified, apparently. On top of that, there's the ultimate martial artist, the ultimate fanfic creator. Hey look, it's Trip Sis, the ultimate gambler. This is kinda ghetto. The ultimate swimming pro, the ultimate programmer, the ultimate clairvoyant, and there's some. There's some, then some. Reading that made me realize how totally powerless I was. It was the country's finest, top to bottom. I don't know, if a fanfic writer can get in, I'm pretty sure you're not that far to the bottom. I felt like a tame little house cat who'd wandered into a pride of lions. That's still pretty kinky. But still, there was something I couldn't stop thinking about. You see, there were a few students who I couldn't find any info on, no matter how much I looked. Just like the boner I can't find right now. With all those ultimate students, I'm the only one without any kind of worthwhile talent. Something tells me he might be the best at being kinky. But then, what about those other new students who didn't seem to pop up anywhere? Could they be just average students like me, without any talent or anything? That thought was kind of encouraging. I mean, I know I don't have much in the way of personality. But beyond that, there's an even bigger issue. My shoes are untied! How did such an unbelievably average student like me get picked to come into this ultimate high school? He's the type of kid who raises his hand and goes- I mean, I guess there is a reason. You just have to take one glance at the acceptance letter they sent me to see why.
What a twist.
We recently held a lottery to select one ordinary student to attend our school. Damn, Shoddy, you like average depressed guys, lip by emoji. As a result, you have been selected, and we invite you to join us as the ultimate lucky student. How sad. They spelled it out plain as day. I got invited by pure luck. Damn, they wrote you in the entrance paper. Honestly, I probably would have been better off just declining their offer. But after hearing how graduating was a guarantee for success later in life, I just couldn't say no. But then, actually standing there in front of the school, I started to feel lost, like I didn't belong there. I could feel myself losing my nerve. Mom, come pick me up! Kids are selling drugs! But still, I can't just stand here in front of the gate forever. Frozen in place, murmuring to myself, I looked down at the acceptance letter clutched in my hand. Why am I still carrying this thing? It said there'd be a meeting for all incoming students in the main hall at 8 a.m. Who wakes up this fucking early? The meeting still isn't for a little while, but I should probably just head in. Ooh, yeah, let's do this. I gathered up all my determination and tried to act like I'd done this a million times before. And I took my first step toward the main hall. I bet you he wakes up when an alarm goes off instead of setting it up for 30 minutes later. This is where we're supposed to meet, right? I guess I'm the first one here. There's a really elegant clock over in the corner. It says it's 7:10 a.m. The meeting doesn't start until 8 o'clock, so there's still a full 50 minutes left. What a rebel. It makes sense. Nobody else would be here yet. I was so wound up. I got here way too early. How sad. I have plenty of time before the meeting. Just standing around waiting isn't exactly. I should take a look around the school. Maybe that'll help me calm down a little. I am a student here now, so there shouldn't be any problem with me having a look around, right? It'll help me kill some time if nothing else. Trying to play it cool, I took my first step into Hopespeak Academy. It was also my first step towards starting a new life at a new school. At least that's what I was hoping for. Then I started tripping balls out of nowhere. I shouldn't have eaten those edibles. What the? But the instant I took that first step forward, my view became warped and twisted. I was high off my ass. It was like some kind of delusion melting away and mixing together into something else. Spinning, sorry. Mixing, melting away, then spinning again. Maybe I just had my filters on wrong. And the next moment, everything went black, or maybe that's just the chroma key. That was how it all began, and how life as I knew it came to an end. At that point, I should have realized The reason I was brought to Hope's Peak Academy wasn't because I had ultimate good luck. It was so I could experience ultimate despair. How fucking sad. Welcome to Despair, the prologue. Goddamn. Oh no, the screen went off because I spent too much being Burger King foot lettuce.
Don't tell me that caught off.
No, he forgot to eat breakfast. This is what happens. Tripping one.
Shit, that's a little right. I don't care.
Oh no, I was procrastinating in the middle of class.
Should I wait a little bit?
No, it's just slow on the thing.
Okay.
Sounds like high school.
Keep going though.
What? Yeah, keep going. Where am I? I woke up with my head resting on top of a hard wooden desk. Must have overslept again. My body feels heavy, arms weak, mom's spaghetti. It's pretty normal for me to zonk off in the middle of some boring class or whatever, but... What was I doing asleep here just now? This isn't a classroom I've ever been in before. What the heck is going on? Dreaming about pants! Dreaming about dicks.
Oh my god, whoa.
Welcome to Hope Speak Academy. Well, wait, hold on. I need to do a proper voice for the
fucking... Welcome to Hope Speak Academy! Firstly, we'd like to explain the big thing.
Go. What a lightweight. I bet he only listens to Drake and doesn't know about girls.
You can use the lipstick to adjust your aim. If you aim at an object that you can interact with, you can press the A button.
Who the fuck is this narrator?
And presto, you'll investigate that object.
Okay. Let's skip this. We don't need to know about the controls.
Skippy skip.
Skippity skip skip. Hi, these are things you don't need to read because you're not... Soli, what are you doing up so late? I'm just finishing up this assignment and see you live.
Oh my god.
It's called Rayman 2 Can Suck My Ass.
Rayman 2.
We tried setting it up, and we were supposed to be live streaming by 11, but then it didn't want to work.
I got this ring.
What the heck? In any normal classroom, that there's a window, that's where a window should be.
Oh my god.
But it looks like some kind of metal plate has been bolted over it. And Raymond too will gladly do so, yep. And if I were to knock on it, bang bang! Yep, definitely metal, thick too, very solid.
Oh, that's
weird. Wait, that's not what matters here. More importantly, why are there metal plates over the windows?
Oh my god.
He locked them thick and solid. Yeah, but I had a lot of work to do, which took me mostly the whole day to finish. Very kinky. Is that a surveillance camera? Oh great, everyone can watch. It's a dangerous world we live in. I guess they have to keep these to keep weirdos from just wandering in. Hi, a shrimp nerd. Hi, Reuben. I've seen you. I've just been too busy reading. Sorry. Hello. Jeez, I can't believe it's already 8 o'clock. It was just after 7 when I first got here. Has it really been almost an hour since then? What the fuck did I eat?
That's the word I'm ignoring.
By the way, Shrimp Sis likes exploring everything, so prepare for that. There's a TV. I wonder if I can watch Barney. The school is funded by the national government, so I guess it's not that weird to have TVs in here. Wonder if they can have the backyardigans. Something feels off. I wonder what it is. He only lost 1 hour in bed, but that's the desk I fell asleep on. I can still see a line of drool I must have left there. Disgusting. Disgusting! I'll have to clean that up later. No, clean it up right now. Use your shirt. Not even an hour. He only lost 1 minute instead of 30 seconds like me. Hey, what's on that desk? An orientation guide? It's some kind of cheap-looking pamphlet, and there's something handwritten on it. The next semester is about to start. Starting today, this school will be your entire world. What the hell? Is this someone's idea of a joke? That's not Joel! Movie! Okay, let's see. So what might have happened is... I got myself so wound out, I passed out in the main hall, and then someone carried me here? If that's true, it must mean... Someone was checking me out and I didn't- I mean, this is a classroom inside Hope's Peak. But then if that's true, then someone was checking me out and I Then that just raises more questions. This is all really strange. Aren't you gonna wonder if someone was checking you out, though? I mean, look at the camera. I mean, those metal plates covering the windows. It's like it's a prison or something. It's a sex dungeon. None of this makes any sense. I should probably head back to the main hall. If the camera guy caught him being kinky in 4K! It's already past the meeting time. There might be other students there by now. You can leave the pass and press the B button! No, shit! No!
Sorry!
No! Okay, cool. We need to leave. Leave the area? Fuck. Jeez, this hallway is kinda weird too. This is getting stranger by the second, but not as strange as me. I honestly have no idea what's going on. This game is too kinky for me, goodnight, New Shane. Well, for now, I'll just head to the main hall. Bye-bye. We don't need that. Also, you can pat the shrimp. Hold up. Pause, shrimp sis. We got this isn't plugged in, that's why. We got a redeem to pat the shrimp, so hold on, I need to abide.
You can't let me pause anyway, so I'm just gonna stand still.
We need to pat the shrimp. Hold on.
Pat the shrimp, what's that?
Pat the shrimp. Exactly what it sounds like. Pat the shrimp.
Oh, the creepy hand.
The creepy hand! Yeah, you don't like the pet hand.
No.
Thank you for the pets. They're really appreciated. You get some too.
No, you bruise me!
You bruise me! Okay, fine. The pets are all mine then. Whatever, you can't appreciate them.
You'll bruise this apple.
Anyway, let's put that away. Thank you, Shadowhunter, for the redeem. Wait, hold on, before we go on. There we go, continue.
Where am I?
Why do you still have the thing up?
I don't remember where I'm going, okay?
Also, sorry that we're being weird. It's just that time of the night. By the time I got back to the main hall, everyone else was already there. Number 15, showing up to the meeting late. You're always weird. Sorry.
Huh? Then you guys are all...
Yeah, we're all new here. Today's supposed to be our first day of class. So, counting him, that makes 15. Seems like a good cutoff point, but I wonder if this is everyone.
I don't know if you can hear the voice acting, so I just turned it up. Oh, this is regular stuff, not weird. Standing before me were the ultimate students that had been handpicked by the school. I looked around at everyone who'd gathered there, taking in their faces one at a time. God, some of these guys are handsome. Maybe I was just imagining it, but I swear I could feel a kind of aura coming from each of them. Hi, Vagrant! Welcome to the chat! Hello! I'm here with Shrimp Sis. Hello. How's it going? My name is Makoto Naegi. Sorry I'm late. A bunch of stuff happened, and then all of a sudden, I was just asleep.
Huh?
Whoa, you too? Oh, wait, no, I need to make a better voice. What voice should I do?
Suggestions
for a voice. Just numbing the foods. Well, I hope that is some really good food. Surfer dude. Whoa, you too, broski?
Oh my god.
Hold on. Things just keep getting curiouser and curiouser.
That's terrible French, I'm sorry.
Vampire, okay. Things just keep getting curiouser and curiouser.
I'm just making her the count, okay? Continue.
Then the count needs to be deeper than that.
No, she's the female count.
Mm-hmm.
So strange. I declare beyond a shadow of a doubt that this is a strange situation indeed.
I love
She's
you.
Kinda hot.
I love you for me. I love you for my voice already.
What are you talking about? I honestly have no idea what's going on right now.
Got it!
Just a moment! There's something else we must address! I don't know. Hold on, I need to make a better voice. That's a terrible voice. Loud. loud, but it has to be just loud. Just a moment! There's something else we must
address. Grinda?
Just a moment! There's something else! Just continue. We'll bust out the kinks later. Perfect.
Well, one day you got your approval. Perfect.
Continue.
Listen to me!
Makoto, your tardiness is unacceptable! Surely you were aware the meeting was about to start at 8 a.m. sharp! To be late on your first day is unspeakable! I must report you, and you must accept your due punishment! Ew!
What?
What's your problem? It's not like he wanted to be late. He didn't have any control over it.
Oh my god!
Like,
what's wrong?
Hold on,
Everyone, just calm down. Listen, why don't we all go around and introduce ourselves?
May I pick you?
Bubbly.
Can nothing be bubbly?
Hold on. If we're doing bubbly.
Everyone, just calm down. Why don't we just all go around and introduce ourselves?
Oh my god, no. Huh? You have to add it. The hell? Now's no time for friggin' introductions.
Maybe, but it may be good to at least find out who we all are before digging into the bigger problems here. I mean, how are we even supposed to talk to each other if we do not know each other's names?
Yeah,
that's a good point.
Okay, so let's get introductions out of the way, then we can move on to whatever else. Sound good? I'm still totally lost, but I think it's best to just focus on getting to know each other for now. Burger King photos. So I guess this is as good a chance as I'm gonna get. I already looked everyone up on that Hopespeak Academy thread online, but I still don't really know what kind of people they actually are. Time to find out. Just choose at random. I'll start by talking to those five over there, and they're gonna do the talking for me, thankfully. So that you don't hear my terrible voice.
Most of it, I guess.
Most of it.
Not that you'll remember my name anyway, but I'm Toko. Toko Fukawa.
Ultimate running prodigy. Yeah, she wrote a novel when she was 10 that got everyone talking and launched her literary career. Then 2 years ago, she released Solinger's The Ocean, a love story said to be her masterpiece.
The book was such a hit with women that fishermen quickly shot to the top of every hottest men pole. Despite her age, she won countless literary prizes and all her books are instant bestsellers. Which is why she's come to be known as the ultimate writing prodigy. What else would you call such a young and talented author? But I figure she'd be a lovey-dovey type, with her masterpiece being a romance and all.
What's your problem?
What? It's not polite to stare, you know?
Why?
I can't do that voice.
What the heck?
Stop staring at me like I'm some filthy creature!
Serena from the Canadian dub. Okay, she's just Serena from the Canadian dub of Sailor Moon.
Filthy creature. No, I just thought.
I know what you just thought! You just thought you'd never seen such an ugly woman! You just thought it was so funny!
No, that's not what I was thinking at all.
I'm telling you!
Don't bother trying to lie to me! I know it's true, otherwise you... I know you can't stand looking at me!
Anyway...
Whatever, I don't really care, I'm used to it!
Wow, talk about an inferiority complex. I was way off about what a successful author would be like.
I am Hifumi Yamada, but if you want to call me by my nickname...
The Alpha and the Omega!
I don't mind.
The fucking voice!
Ultimate Perfect Creator.
Mm-hmm.
By the way, how much did you know about the world of 2D art? World of 2D? Well, in that world, I'm well known and supremely well regarded as the Ultimate Perfect Creator.
Mm-hmm.
I once sold 10,000 copies of one of my fan comics at a school festival. The event has passed into legend. Some of them didn't even get it, of course, saying I tainted the event. How stupid can you be?
That's too bad about them, but selling 10,000 copies like that is definitely pretty remarkable. He makes rule 34!
However...
The words of this idiot mean nothing to me. I'm like Van Gogh, utterly unappreciated in my time. I am a soldier, serving night and day to destroy all mindless preconceptions about fanfiction. I'm sure if you were to observe my work, Mr. Nagy, you would comprehend its greatness immediately.
Mm-hmm.
For my work is filled with deepest meaning.
What kind of meaning?
Yes, indeed.
It's about embracing our basest urges.
I don't think I want to comprehend it. Gross. I'm kinky, but I won't touch that.
Hi, I'm Sayaka Maizono. I look forward to getting to know you.
I forgot her voice. Continue. I'll get it.
Mellow? Okay, this is Mellow.
The ultimate pop sensation.
The way she moves is positively mesmerizing, and that pleasant sense I can't quite place. I'm being such a creep! Sayaka Maizono. When I saw her name in that thread online, frankly, I was pretty surprised. She's in a pop group famous all across the country. In fact, she's their lead singer. As the ultimate pop sensation, she's in high demand to appear on TV and in magazines everywhere. But actually, that's not the only reason I was so surprised to find out she'd be going to this school. I'm sure she doesn't remember, but... Well, never mind. No matter how you slice it, she's really beautiful. Almost like a doll or something.
I'm not a doll, you know. I'm alive.
Huh? Did you hear me?
I'm psychic.
Witch!
Huh?
Kidding. I just have really good intuition.
She's a sharp one.
Hey,
Huh. Hey, way by any chance. Now what?
Huh?
Yeah, it must be. I'm sure of it. Hey, Makoto, dude.
Just hold on!
Jeez, you guys! How long do you plan to waste our valuable time with this ridiculous back and forth?
Sorry, I just got carried away, I guess.
You hear me?
Self-introductions are for introducing yourself, not fumbling through a bunch of idle chit-chat!
You're right.
She will find out about our kinky ways! No!
Sorry,
Makoto. We can talk about this later.
Actually, we can't, since I just read that, we can't talk about this. It sounded like Sayaka really had something she wanted to say. White suit man saved us! But it's not like we'll never see each other again. Like she said, we can talk later. Oh no, my voice.
I'm Kiyotaka Ishimaru. I believe in bold simplicity. Let's work together on our educational
crusade.
Those
eyebrows are boss, though. Can I somehow grow eyebrows like that? Please? Ultimate moral compass. Hey, look, it's me!
So that's Kiyotaka, according to what I saw about him on that thread. He went to a famous private school and won top honors every year. He's basically a flawless honor student.
Hey, no, it's roasting me alive! The game's roasting me!
He's also known for the work he's done with his community's public morals committee. They say he respects rules above all else, earning him the title of Ultimate Moral Compass.
No, stop calling me out! Anyway, you can call me Taka. You said your name was Makoto Nagi, right? That's a good name! A strong name! You should thank your parents for giving you such an excellent name!
You hear me?
And to keep that name from losing its value, you must devote yourselves every single day!
Got it!
Life is worth putting every ounce of effort into it, right? Right!
This guy is kind of annoying.
He sounds like my uncle!
Yo, the name's Leon Kawada. What's up?
You know what? Someone's gonna have the toad voice. Leon's gonna have the toad. No, wait, no. Leon's not gonna have the toad voice. No. A certain someone else is gonna have the toad voice because I can't stand him.
Surprise me.
Leon Kawada, Ultimate Baseball Club.
I recognize that name. He played for the National High School Champs as their cleanup hitter, the Ultimate Baseball Star. And that superb athletic specimen is... You? Seriously? Leon is a hottie!
Huh?
Huh?
Oh wait, no, hold on. What's wrong?
Oh my god!
Hold on, I mean, Wumi said he's a hottie. I have to make him sound as much of a hottie as I can. I'll fail, but I'm trying.
Wait, hottie as in,
hottie. Oh my god, I'm Duke Devlin. What's wrong?
Nothing, I'm just surprised. I figured with you being the ultimate baseball star and all.
Give me a break.
What? Were you expecting some kid with a shaved head? No, I was just expecting more of a, you know, sporty-looking traditional baseball player type. I mean, when I found that article and picture of you online, that's how you looked then. He's a hottie with a body. What? Oh man, you found that picture of me playing baseball? Seriously, I hate that picture.
What the crap?
This is not cool. This is so not cool. Seriously, like, mega embarrassed right now. I didn't have a choice, okay? Shaving your head like that is part of national championship regulations.
Seriously?
Now I refuse to cut my hair, and I'm not gonna dye it back to normal either.
Hey, listen.
Actually, can I be totally honest with you? Anything?
You know,
I don't like baseball, like at all. I've never found it. He's never practiced, and he was still his team star player? That's some kind of prodigy. Never mind, he's ugly! Too late, the voice has already been established! And as soon as I got accepted here, I quit baseball for good. I had my own dream for the future. a dream for the future.
You ruined it for them.
No, I don't think I ruined it for him. My only path in life is getting into music. I can feel that stuff going more.
You know what I mean.
I'm gonna be a singer, so all I need is a songwriter and someone on guitar and we're set.
How cool is that?
This new version of me that's chasing after my dream is like super cool to Max. I can't believe what I'm hearing. I've never imagined I'd hear something like that from a baseball all-star. It's like super cool. Yes. Okay, now to talk to those five people over there.
I'm Junko Enoshima. Charmed, I'm sure.
The ultimate fashionista! Anybody would recognize this one. She's got more charm and presence than any high school girl in the country. She's the ultimate fashionista. I've seen her on tons of magazine covers, but... I feel like that doesn't quite match up to reality.
What?
Huh?
Come on.
Oh, are you talking about my cover photos and junk? Well, of course. Those are totally photoshopped. Photoshopped? Yeah, you know, edited to hell and back with, like, computers and junk. Oh, so they aren't real?
What can we do?
Don't act so surprised. You're gonna make me all depressed.
Totally.
It's totally normal these days to Photoshop the crap out of cover photos. If you're surprised by that, you'd be totally blown away by a certain dangerous little diva of yours. They make the eyes and chin super big and tweak the skin so it looks all ceramic and porcelain. Oh. My boner is gone! So many dreams are getting crushed today! Can I ask you your name?
My name is Kyoko Kirigiri.
Ultimate! She's pretty tight-lipped, huh? Oh, but you know, her name didn't show up anywhere in that Hope Speak Academy thread. And I did see that there were students like me, ones who didn't have any real identity or presence. Could this girl be one of them? So, what are you doing at this school?
What?
What's that supposed to mean? No, I just meant getting invited here means you're some kind of ultimate something, right? So what ultimate something are you?
That doesn't matter.
Why should I tell you? Huh? Well, I guess you don't have to tell me.
Whew.
No, I don't have to tell you, so I'm not going to. Nothing about her turned up online, so I was thinking maybe she got picked by chance like me, but... Ultimate hard to get! There we go, that's her talent. Ultimate hard to get. Figured it out.
Dot.
Her face is like an iron mask. If she doesn't want to tell me anything, no point in asking.
Hello, nice to meet you. I'm Chihiro Fujisaki.
Ultimate programmer. Sorry, I get kind of embarrassed whenever I introduce myself like this. Anyway, I hope we can get along. Same here, nice to meet you.
Huh?
Maybe it's just my imagination, but have we met before? I don't think so. We just met for the first time, which is why I said nice to meet you.
I'm sorry.
Yeah, good point. Sorry.
You don't have to apologize for that.
Yeah.
Shihiro Fujisaki is known for all the cutting-edge programs she's created. She's the ultimate programmer. She's also got that timid little bunny type thing going, which has endeared her to her legion of fans.
So listen.
Maybe she's an X-Fling.
I'm really sorry.
What are you apologizing for now?
Well, just cause you seem upset.
You must be mad at me, right? No, not at all. I was just lost in thought about something.
Huh? Lost in thought?
Yeah, it had nothing to do with me being upset or anything.
Thank you.
Oh, that's
good. I was afraid maybe you didn't like me. I'm glad. I'm starting to understand why her fans are so into her.
Heya! I'm Aoi Asahina, but my friends just call me Hina. Sup?
Swimming pro. Aoi Asahina, she's been breaking records in every competition she's been in since elementary school. She's even been chosen as an upcoming Olympic cadet. She is, without a doubt, the ultimate swimming pro. The combination of her ability, appearance, and, proportion has been widely discussed online. What was your name again? Sorry, I totally forgot. Makoto Naegi. Oh yeah, I knew it was something like that. No, not something like that. It is that.
You got it!
Sure, got it. Here, I'll hammer it into my brain right now.
Yeah!
Makoto Naegi. Makoto Naegi. The system is down! The system is down! She just kept repeating my name and moving her finger across the palm like she was writing something. What are you doing?
Huh?
You don't know? If you want to remember someone's name, you gotta write it on your hand 3 times. I've never heard of that before in my life. Hey, by the way, how do you spell your last name? You spell it exactly as it sounds. It's me. Well, I have no idea. I'll just figure it out later and write it down.
Okay.
Anyway, glad to meet ya. Sure, same here. Well, one thing I learned is she's totally easygoing and bursting with energy. Oh no, this guy.
Name's Mondo Iwata. Nice to fucking meet ya.
The ultimate biker gang leader! He's a baddie, fucka.
He's a baddie!
Mondo Iwata, huh? Which means... he's the current leader of the largest biker gang in Japan. He's earned respect, even awe, from every gang in the country. He's the ultimate biker gang leader. You know, like what happened with Leon? For Wooby?
Wait, what?
So what happened with Leon with Wooby?
I guess?
Yeah.
Wait, what do you mean?
Huh? What were you meaning with that?
Did obviously, it's the complete opposite.
You want me to give him a chihuahua voice?
I guess.
You want me to give him a chihuahua? He's gonna sound like Elmo.
Oh my god.
Nice to meet you too. Yes!
Oh my god! Approved.
No. Okay.
Hell yeah!
Oh, come on, is your Elmo voice?
Yeah, you know what? He'll be Mickey Mouse instead.
Oh no.
Hell yeah!
Oh my god.
I better be careful around him. One wrong word and I could wake up at the bottom of the sea.
Okay, I take it back.
Where are you going? Alaska!
Please stop.
Those four over there are the only ones left.
Oh, yeah!
Togami.
The ultimate affluent progeny!
Hi, nice to meet you.
That's the most half-assed introduction I've ever heard. But there isn't really anything I can do about it. Even among the ultimate students, this one is special. Yakuya Togami, he's the heir apparent of his family's massive financial conglomerate. I had a stroke. He's already started managing business operations and his own personal Alice are, well, fast. He is hot and rich. No!
No.
Look at that Karen haircut. No, no, no. He's gonna be towed. His title of Ultimate Affluent Progeny is completely accurate. He's the definition of exceptional. No! Not Karen! That's everything I learned about him from that Hope Speak Academy thread online.
Come on.
I'm done with introductions, right? How much longer are you going to stand there? Go away! I'm sick of looking at you! You're just sitting on the castle!
In our history, you and I will never stand on the same level, like a king in training. He's just toad.
I'm Yasuhiro Hagakure. Hero for short. Take it easy, yeah? I know I will.
Oh look, Surfer Dude's back. The ultimate clairvoyant. Captain Toad has entered the chat! Yasuhiro Hagakure, also known as Supernova in the psychic community, the trend-setting ultimate clairvoyant. Honestly, I don't really get all that fortune-telling stuff. He's pretty much beyond me. Still, I can't help wondering if there's any truth to it.
Could it be?
Server dude likes vape. Okay, I give up. What happened?
For serious?
I saw it! I looked right at it! Seriously, I totally saw it, broski! Saw what? A guardian angel with a crazy perm chasing after Bigfoot running off with a skyfish in its mouth.
Oh, shit.
Shaw! Shaw! And that guardian angel is your guardian angel, bruh! Nah, I'm just kidding. But hey, we should grab some brewskis sometime and get real deep into Lemuria and its civilization. He's at brewskis! He's the surfer dude! What? We're not allowed to drink. We're in high school.
You know?
Oh, I'm actually 21. I've been held back a few times, Sam. Well, it's a long story. A few times? Yeah, I bet that is a long story.
I am Sakura Ogami.
Martial artist. Oh jeez, I almost asked her if she was a guy. I don't know. She is hot! Me too, Wumi, me too!
You got good taste.
You got good taste. Mommy, take me. The day I saw something like that out loud, the day I say something like that out loud is the day I get turned into a human meatball. I don't know, but now I remember she competed in a martial arts tournament in America and won, despite being a girl. That's how you get banned.
Wait, what?
To chatbots. She's the ultimate martial artist. She's fought in over 400 matches and never lost a single one. Oh, there was a chatbot. That thread also said a bit more about her. Some call her ogre. Some even think she's the closest known relative to the primates, the famed missing link. That's just rude. Any incoming Hope Speak Academy students who are reading this, let me warn you right now. If you value your life, avoid her at all costs. Stand
standing in front of her now. I don't think they were exaggerating about that.
Hey.
Hey, ew.
Yes? I snapped to attention without even realizing it. That dummy mommy energy. Then she started to poke and prod at my body. Ooh, ooh. what are you?
I see.
Muscular quality and quantity is right around that of an extremely ordinary high school student. Hmm. Please hug me with your big, big arms. Me too. What a shame. You're not at all fit to act as my brain. You're not at all fit to act as my training partner. And that's such a shame for me.
It is a shame. Okay, count.
I do not think we have been introduced. I am Celestia Ludenberg.
Both of a gambler. Yes, I'm a vampire! Celestia Ludenberg.
Hey, Ludenberg. It's my name, but if you don't mind, I would prefer for you to call me Celeste.
You are Japanese, right?
Huh?
Of course. Why do you ask?
If you don't mind, could you tell me your real name?
I don't know what you're talking about. Celestia Ludenberg is my real name. But as I mentioned, I would much rather you call me Celeste.
She's polite, but pretty forceful at the same time. I don't think she wants to say any more about it. I guess the rumors in that thread were right about her. The self-styled Celestia Ludenberg, she's the ultimate gambler who's never lost a man. Other than her obvious love of gothic Lolita clothes, everything about her is wrapped in a veil of lies. They say that she entered and won an underground gambling tournament, earning the title Queen of Liars. She totally cleaned out the other players, taking their life savings and laughing as she did it.
I look forward to getting to know you better.
Yumeko, is that you? That smile is beyond deceptive. I'd better watch myself around her. I'd rather watch myself.
Oh my god.
And with that, all the introductions are done. Even though they're all ultimate, they each have their own individual sort of, something. That's true. I think someone said something about a bigger problem or something. What was that about?
Listen.
Oh, you see?
Makoto,
you said a bunch of stuff happened and then you were just asleep, right? Well, that thing is true for all of us. We all took edibles.
Oh my god.
What? Seriously? I thought I was the only one.
I mean, seriously?
Just as each of us got to the main hall, we lost consciousness. And when we came to, we were somewhere in the school. That's what happened to you, right?
But that's just weird. That every single one of us would eat an edible like that.
Piece of shit!
Exactly! That's why we're all freaking out!
Why?
Because he's Mickey Mouse now! And that's not the only thing! You saw where all the windows in the classes of the Nevada were, right?
What?
I had a stroke!
English!
You saw where all the windows in the classes and hallways were, right? But instead of normal glass windows, it was a bunch of big metal plates! What was that about?
Are you for real?
Plus, all my stuff's missing, even my cell phone.
Yeah, you're right. I haven't seen my PDA in
there
either.
And then there's the main hall here! The front exit is completely blocked by some giant metal hatch!
What does this mean?
But there wasn't anything like that when I first got here!
What the heck?
What the heck? What's he doing here?
So
poor. Ishimaru's constantly having a stroke. Oh no! Maybe we got caught up in some kind of, like, you know, crime or something?
Is it, like...
Is that a machine gun in the background? Yes. What, like, a kidnapping?
Do you think maybe someone grabbed us and hauled us off and we're not actually at school?
Hey, come on.
Come on, bruh. Don't think like that. Cheer up. I bet this is all just part of the school's orientation procedure. Sure.
You know?
Yeah, I'm sure that's it. So I'm just gonna take it easy for a moment.
I see.
Oh, so you think they wanted to do something to surprise us?
What the hell?
Well, if that's all it is, it's nap time for me.
You know what I mean.
I was up way too late last night, so I could use a little shot. I could feel everyone's tension evaporating. But then it began. Five Nights at Freddy's!
Hello, welcome to Five Nights at Freddy's.
Five Nights at Freddy's.
Old man.
Oh no, it's a fucking bear!
Testing, testing. Mic check, 1, 2. This is a test of the school broadcast system.
Oh.
Am I on? Can everyone hear me?
Never mind, Freddy's
okay,
back.
Well then.
The voice seemed totally out of place. It was so playful, so completely unconcerned. I couldn't help but feel a deep, unnerving dread at the sound of it. It was like hearing someone laugh at the scene of an accident.
To all incoming students, I would like to begin the entrance ceremony at... right now!
It's me!
Please make your way to the gymnasium at your earliest convenience. That's all. I'll be waiting.
What the hell was that just now?
Goodbye.
Cloudon, if you'll excuse me!
Hey!
Hey! You're just gonna take off like that?
Could it be?
Oh yeah, now I get it. This whole thing was to just get us all pumped for the entrance ceremony. Yeah, bro! Man, thank God it was all a joke. I'd be totally freaked if this was real.
You know?
Alright, guess I'll head out too. Wonder what they got planned for us next.
Damn,
I was totally looking forward to that nap too. Why'd they have to go again with me?
Huh?
Wait for me. I want to go with you. That is that, Ben. I'll go see you all there.
Anyway.
Not that anyone cares, but I'm gonna go too. Everyone took off for the gym, but I was frozen where I stood. That uneasy feeling I'd had before, I couldn't get it out of my mind. And it looked like I wasn't the only one. This doesn't seem right.
This is bad.
Yeah, that announcement was totally weird.
However...
maybe, but just staying put doesn't mean we'll be safe. Besides, aren't you guys just a little bit curious as to find out what's going on around here?
I see.
If we do not move forward, we learn nothing. The only choice is to push ahead. I guess she's right. But still, I'm kinda, no, really nervous. We don't have a choice. We have to go. They said to go to the gym, right? Do you want to save the data?
Yeah.
This is really long.
Where have we done, though?
Yeah. Bathroom break. Sis is gonna take a bathroom break, so we're gonna go ahead and head over to our break. So hold up a sec while I switch you guys over and get some music playing. Okay, be right back.
We're back. Ugh. We're back. Yeah. I've returned with water and cookies. I'm not sharing. No!
Water and cookies?
Yes.
Well.
Are you okay? Is everyone okay?
Huh.
True. If we do not move forward, we learn nothing. The only choice is to push ahead.
I just love the song of the red beat and song you say something.
Listen.
I know how you feel, but all we can do now is check it out.
This is bad.
Oh, what was with that announcement? It was like totally creepy.
Shit.
Shit! What the hell kind of game are they playing? You thought I was gonna do something normal. What the hell? Is this some kind of bad joke? Look, my dedication to voices is real. But yeah, those are the-
Something weird is going on here, right? It's not just me.
But see, those were the guns that Wumi was talking about.
What?
The guns!
Oh. Oh yes,
those are real. Those are real! Yeah, learn how to walk. We still haven't recovered from the edible problem.
Hey, come on!
God, I have no idea this Hope Stick Academy with plays was gonna be such a pain in my balls! It really ain't that much different from the time I spent in Juvie! Hell, this place is even worse!
And why isn't there anyone here? Walking through the halls, I didn't see a single person.
This is bad.
Isn't that, like, seriously not good? They're just trying to spook us! I'll take those metal plates down later, I'm sure of it!
Huh.
All we can do now is hope for the best and prepare for the worst. Nothing ventured, nothing gained.
Shit.
Well, hell! It ain't like I'm scared or nothing! Let's just get this over with, huh? No, I will not.
Hey, damn it.
Hey! Where's whoever called us here?
What are you thinking?
Understand! No running!
Well,
I too shall go. Hey, wait! Don't think we are all alone! Okay, that's no tutorial. No tutorial. Fuck ya.
This is bad.
I'm totally getting a bad vibe right now.
Thought. Total silence.
For whatever reason, she's the only one managing to stay calm. Or maybe I'm just imagining that. Where? Okay. Shoot. I had to check because I sometimes get paranoid that I didn't turn the mic on.
Are you serious?
No, I did.
Okay.
Where are all the other students? Why are we the-
Why does water taste so good at night? Because your inner fish is coming out.
Where are all the other students? Why are we the only ones here?
Still filled with an uneasy dread. I did what the announcement said and went to the gym. Blah blah. And I saw what was waiting for us there. My god, they decked this place out. Oh, it really does look like an entrance ceremony.
Yo!
See, told ya, it's totally normal entrance ceremony stuff. Hero was right. And in a way, that just emphasized how completely not normal all of us were.
Hey there, howdy, hello! Is everyone here? Good! Then let's get things rolling!
The old man is here.
Dang it, Grandpa! So Monokuma has to be a grandpa by default. Someone has to be his grandpa.
Hello.
Huh?
It's Fred Bear.
Teddy Bear?
I'm not a teddy bear. I am Monokuma! And I am this school's headmaster.
It was the strangest thing I'd ever seen. Right before my eyes, it was... What I was seeing was... It was utterly incomprehensible.
Nice to meet you all.
Such a bright voice and carefree attitude was completely out of place. And all that anxiety I've been carrying with me suddenly transformed into outright fear.
Say what?
What? The teddy bear can talk! Calm down, I'm sure there's just a speaker inside it.
Hey, come on now.
I told you already, I'm not a teddy bear. Where's my hearing aid?
That's your best old man, boy.
You youngsters need to learn some respect for my old man voice! I'm Monokuma and I'm your handmaster!
Say what?
Ah, it means... Come on, no!
Seriously, man, calm down! It's probably just a remote control toy or something!
How dare you combine me to a drill's plaything! You cut me deep! Deeper than the Mariana Trench, which this streamer calls her home!
Are you serious about
yes. My remote control system is so complex, even the folks at NASA can't recreate or comprehend it. It's probably because it was made in like 10 BC, but we don't talk about that!
Bear it!
Oh, but don't tell me, make me say stuff that might destroy NASA's dreams! I just couldn't bear that!
Bear that? Really? You are unfortunate.
Or, apparently, still a man.
No. I like the old man voice I got. I'm not changing it. Now then, moving on, we must hurry and get started.
Giving up already? No other stupid bear puns?
Now then.
He has abandoned the gag.
Good morning!
Everyone stand attention and bow and good morning!
You hear me?
And good morning!
What's your problem?
You don't have to sit back!
Now then.
Where are my papers and my glasses? Fuck! First, let's talk a bit about what your school like will be like, youngsters. Make no mistakes, you few students of full potential represent the hope of the world in junk. I don't know, I'm too old for this. And to protect such splendid hope, you will all live in a communal life together, solely within the confines of this school. Everyone will live in harmony together and adhere to the rules and regulations of the school. The end date for this communal life.
Too bad.
There is one. I didn't plan ahead that far. In other words, you'll be here until the day you die. Such as the school life you've been assigned.
What did you just say? Die?
Yep.
Oh, fear not. I have quite an abundant budget that you won't lack for all the common conveniences.
Hold on a second.
That's the least of our worries right now.
Yeah, what the hell? You're saying I have to live here forever? You're screwing with us, right?
It's true.
I am not screwing with you! I'm nowhere! I can be 100% sure!
That was an actual cough.
And just for your information, you're completely cut off from the outside world. So you don't have to worry about the dirty, dirty land beyond these walls ever again. I mean, all of the pandemic and stuff. Stay inside, you stupid kids!
Cut off.
So, all those metal plates all over the school. They're there to keep us trapped in here.
Well, yeah, it's to keep the bad pandemic outside.
That's exactly what they're there for. I made them myself. I took the screws and wrench and just good old elbow grease like in the old days. Fuck your machine concert.
Makes very smart and sexy,
no matter how much you may yell and scream, help will not come. It's kind of sad, actually. It's just like when my kids left me in the home. So with all of that in mind, feel free to live out your life here with reckless abandon.
Hey, come on.
Come on. Oh, wait, sorry. Come on. What the hell is this? I don't care if the school or whoever else is behind it all. Oh, this is just a really bad joke.
Damn you!
Yeah, cut the shit out! It isn't funny anymore, huh?
Unbelievable. You keep saying this is a liar joke, but just kept exalting it. God, you're worse than my wife!
What are you gonna do?
Well, I guess you can't help it. I all grew up in a neighborhood and taught to doubt your neighbor. Fucking kids these days. Well, you'll have plenty of time to find out whether or not what I say is true. And when that time comes, you will see with all your own eyeballs that I speak the undeniable truth and nothing but the truth.
Most unfortunate.
Having to live here forever would be quite the problem.
What's this?
Come now, what's the matter with all of you? I thought you kids liked staying indoors, dammit! You decided of your own free will to attend Hope's Peak Academy, didn't you? And now, before the entrance ceremony is even finished, you've already decided you want to leave?
Hey,
Oh, but you know... I guess I did forget to mention one thing. There is one way for you to leave the school. Really?
Actually...
His headmaster has crafted a special clause for those of you who would like to leave. I call it the graduation clause. Made the name himself. Now let me tell you about this fun little rule. It's a tricky one. As I mentioned, in order to maintain an environment of harmony here, we rely on a communal lifestyle. And if someone were to disrupt that harmony, they and they alone would be allowed to leave the school. That, my students, is the graduation clause.
What?
What do you mean by disrupt the harmony?
Well, you know, if one person were to, say, murder another... murder?
Yes, indeed!
Damning, strangling, bludgeoning, crushing, hacking, drowning, igniting... you know, it doesn't matter, get crazy, you wild kids! You must kill someone if you want to leave, it's as simple as that! The rest is up to you. Give it your all to achieve the best outcome in the worst way possible.
A chill shot down my spine. You must kill someone if you want to leave. As soon as I heard those words, my blood went cold.
I bet that got your brain juices flowing. Beats the heck out of a human catching a salmon, huh? Like I said before, you guys are the hope of the world, but you know, taking that hope and seeing it get murdered creates a darkened shadow of despair.
Extreme!
And I just find it so darn exciting!
What the hell?
What the hell are you talking about? To kill each other is it.
Huh?
To kill each other is to kill each other. I'm pretty sure there's a dictionary here somewhere and need it. Fucking, instead of reading your computer machines.
And... What are you saying?
We know what it means. It's not the problem. Why do we have to kill each other?
Say what?
Yeah, stop the ring with all that nonsense. Just let us go home already.
Blabbering. 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 What do you mean blabbering? Stop blabbering on about blabbering on. How strange.
You guys just don't get it, do you? He goes from very annoying voice to old man voice. It's just something weird in his system. Let us go! Let us go! You keep saying the same thing over and over and over and over. Listen, from this moment on, this school is your home, your life, your world. God damn!
Yippee!
And you can kill as much as you want to kill, so go ahead and go on a killing spree! Alright, come on. How long are you gonna keep this up?
Hmm?
It is?
you know?
You got us. Hey, scare the hell out of us. So you can go ahead and reveal the trick now, bruh.
Huh?
Reveal the trick?
I'm right.
Yeah,
right?
Cause I mean, you know, it was all some kind of trick and all, right? So.
Dude, shut
the hell up and get out of my way! Shoving Hiro aside, Mondo placed himself in front of Monokuma, his voice rumbling like thunder.
You're fucking dead.
Listen up, asshole! This shit's gone way too far! What the hell kind of joke is this?
What's the matter?
Joke! You may like your hair!
You son of a bitch!
Ah! The thunder roared out, and then there was a sudden boom. It was the sound of the floorboard that he kicked off and launched himself into the air. Zaddy McSpear got the rose. He flew at Monokuma fast and straight as a bullet. He'd locked onto his target.
Locked on target!
Gotcha, you little piece of shit! I don't know if you're a toy or a stuffed animal or whatever the hell. Either way, I'm gonna rip you to fucking shreds!
Oh.
What? Violence against the headmaster is in violation of school regulations!
Shut the fuck up! Let me out of here, I swear to Christ! Hey, damn it!
What? No smartass comeback this time?
Piece of shit!
He stopped that goddamn baby and say something!
Watch out!
Watch out! Get rid of it!
Huh?
Huh? Hurry up and throw it! I don't know if her ferocity stunned him into silence or what, but without a word he knew what he was told. He threw Monokuma. And as soon as he did... The hell?!
What the?!
That sure as shit wasn't a joke! Blow the hell up! There was a painful ringing in my ears and I could smell gunpowder. Explosions might happen all the time in movies or whatever, but when it's in real life, I've never seen anything like it.
But
no, this means that the teddy bear's been destroyed, right?
Hey!
I told you I'm not a teddy bear in Falcon!
Damn
you! You son of a bitch! You seriously tried to kill me just now!
Of course!
Well, yeah, I was serious about trying to kill you! You did violate one of the school regulations, after all! I'll let you off with a warning this time, Whoop Snapper, but you better be careful from now on! Any naughty boy or girl who violates my rules will get off with just a little swat on the butt!
This is bad.
Hey, so does this mean there's like a bunch more of you around somewhere?
Yep.
Monokuma's has been killing us all throughout the school, yeah. I found myself a fancy cloning machine. Plus, don't forget the surveillance cameras installed everywhere. Looks like I'm wearing a crown, isn't that cute? And if you're caught breaking any rules, well, you all just saw what happened, right? And I won't be so forgiving with my punishment next time, so don't let it happen again. I want to eat my pudding.
That's not even punishment, that's just wrong.
Well?
Now then, Leslie, to commemorate your joyous entry into our school, I have a little something for you.
Ta-da!
This is our official student handbook. Pretty cool, huh? I don't know how this thing works. As you can see, it's fully digital, so naturally we call it... E-Handbook! Yeah, well, moving on. This handbook is absolutely vital to a healthy school life, so don't lose it! When you start it off, it will display your name. Always make sure you have the right one. Now, this is not your everyday notebook. It has so many more uses than that. Man, technology is wonderful. Also, it's completely waterproof. Splash it, watch it, drown it, it'll keep on ticking. You have a great, and thanks to its space age design, it can withstand an impact force of up to 10 tons. Very resistant.
It contains all of our school regulations, so to make sure you review them. So make sure you review them thoroughly. I'm having a stroke again.
You guys.
You hear me say this a lot, but any violation of school regulations will not be tolerated.
Shing.
Rules restrict, yes, but they also protect. Society, for example, would be utter chaos without laws.
Yes, indeed.
The same thing applies here, which is why it's crucial to have strict punishments in place for violators. Okay, well, that brings our entrance ceremony to a close.
Bye-bye.
Please enjoy your abundantly dry school and see ya. There's my pudding.
And with that, he was gone, leaving us all in a state of shock.
So, guys, how would you define what we just experienced? On a scale of 1 to 10, how scary was it?
I don't understand any of this.
We have to live here forever! Kill! What happened?
Calm down.
Everyone, we need to just calm down. First, let's try to take a second to summarize everything we just heard. Based on what Monokuma said, we essentially have two choices. Choice number one is that we each stay here, living a communal life together until the day we die. And the other choice is...
Indeed.
If we want to get up here alive, we have to kill someone, right? But killing someone,
I mean, we're stepped into nowhere and stuffed into this place to look like a skill! And now we're supposed to start killing ourselves? What is this?
Ridiculous!
A lie is what it is! All these ridiculous things we've heard, this all has to be fake! Right! No, it doesn't really matter if it's real or fake! What matters is...
So, in other words...
Is there anybody who seriously is considering all this?
To that, nobody had a response. Even quiet myself, I looked around at the others. Ooh. They all stared at one another, trying to gauge each other's thoughts. I could almost taste the hostility. It tastes delicious. And that's when it hit me. I realized the true terror hidden within the rules Monokuma had laid out. You must kill someone if you want to leave. Those words had planted vicious thoughts deep within each of us. Each of us became suspicious of everyone else. We were forced to wonder, is somebody going to betray us? And that was how my new school life began. Working for lettuce. The school which had come out of nowhere to raise my hopes so high. It's not a school of hope. It's a school of despair. Oh! What the please? We finished the prologue after almost 2 hours. Surviving students, 15. Cool. Let's hope it stays that way. To be continued. Oh no. Hey, look, it's the opening again. I don't know. I'll probably skip it. We're skipping it. We already saw it. I'm sorry. You received the school crest present! Hell yeah, yeah, yeah! Oh. You must kill someone if you wanna leave. I'm sorry, you have to wait until he can pause and quit. My mind froze and my breath caught in my throat as I thought about that. I could feel a paralyzing fear slowly making its way through my body, dominating every last nerve. The air hung heavy on me, pressing down like a weight around my neck. It kind of felt good because of how kinky I am.
Oh my god.
It took everything I had just to endure that weight. That sweet, sweet weight.
To survive, chapter 1, daily life. Not as for, but for as heavy as the air felt. You're making me laugh. I need to do Burger King foot lettuce voice.
all it took to pierce it was her sharp words.
And?
So, what are you going to do now?
Hey.
Just stand around, glaring at each other. Her pointed comment was directed at everyone in the room. It helped pull us all back to reality. Oh, there goes gravity. Oh, there goes gravity. Yo, you gotta lose yourself. Right! She's right!
Listen to me!
Sometimes even if you're nervous or afraid, you just have to step forward! To forget such a simple fact! I can't forget myself! I'm so ashamed!
You hear me?
Please! Someone hit me! I can't forget myself! Somebody hit me! Punish me! Oh, masochist. Huh? Jesus, if you have time to yell about it, you have time to do something about it.
However...
Perhaps, but this is missing exactly.
Stupid.
Idiot, to look for a way out, duh.
What the...
And we totally need to find whoever was controlling that stupid bear and beat the hell out of him.
But
before we do all that, maybe we should take a look at the handbook. It's probably best to check out the school regulations Monokuma mentioned before doing anything else.
This is fine.
True. If we stumble around with no clue what the rules are, something like that might happen again. Shit!
Alright, so
fine, then let's hurry up and check out the stupid rules already! Hensei. Makoto Mike. After turning on my EM book, the first thing that appeared was my name. So just like Monokuma said, the owner's name showed up front and center. Then from the main menu that popped up, I selected the school regulations icon. We're teaching you how to use this thing, okay? An itemized list appeared on screen. It was school regulations. In other words, the rules being imposed on us all. Students may recite only within the school. Leaving campus is an unacceptable use of time. Night time is from 10 p.m. to 7 a.m. Some areas are off limits only, so please exercise caution. Sleeping anywhere other than the dormitory will be seen as sleeping in class and punished accordingly. With minimal restrictions, you are free to explore Clubspeak Academy at your discretion. Violence against Headmaster Monokuma is strictly prohibited, and as is destruction of surveillance cameras. He's old, okay? Be gentle. Oh yeah! I'm sorry, let me do that again.
Violence against Lenny Grandpa is strictly forbidden. He's old, okay? As is destruction of surveillance cameras. Anyone who kills a fellow student and becomes blackened will graduate unless they are discovered. Additional school regulations may be added as necessary. Additional data rates may apply. I'm here to call about your cards and send your warranty.
Oh my god.
Feeling a slight dizziness, I raised my face up from the screen. As I looked around, I saw the same stormy expression on everyone's faces.
Stop fucking around!
This is bullshit! What the hell kind of rules are these? I'm not gonna let them control me! Oh, I'm gonna fucking melt!
Well then, why don't you wander around the school without a care in the world to see what happens? Personally, I would love to see what happens when someone breaks one of the rules.
However...
But if you got punished like what we saw before, I didn't think there would be a respawn waiting for him. Dot.
Yo.
Ever since I was a kid, I grew up with my older brother pounding this into my head. When a man makes a promise, he has to keep it, even if it kills him.
And...
So what?
What?
I've made a ton of promises that I still have to keep, that's so what?
Piece of shit!
I can't afford to die in here, huh?
None of that made much sense to me, but you are saying you will follow the regulations, is that it?
That's true.
Oh, well, yeah, I guess you're right.
Hey, I have a question. For regulation number 6, what do you think it means exactly? Anyone who kills, we already read this.
Yeah. You already read this.
You're talking about the second half, right? right, where it says unless they are discovered. I was wondering about that myself.
I say that if you're not good anyway, you have to kill someone without anyone finding out it was you!
Why? Why do we have to do that?
I don't see any reason to lie about it. This way we're not following the rules that they've been explained to us.
Such ignorance.
Frankly, I don't want to hear anything from someone who waits for others to decide what to do for them.
Don't jab at me!
Give me a break.
More like a false stab. Well, for now, let's forget all that silly junk about murderers or whatever.
Okay.
Now that we know the rules, let's start exploring the school.
Crew, we need to find out where exactly we are! Is there any way out? What about food and supplies?
You understand?
There are tons of questions we need to answer!
Let's do it!
Damn straight! Okay, let's all start looking around.
I'll be going alone!
What?
What? Why? That's a pretty stupid idea, don't you think?
Some of you might have already started thinking about murdering one of us. I say we just stand around with them in our midst and make it that much easier for them?
Hold on a second.
Wait, hold on a second. That would never...
What?
Don't bother saying it couldn't happen! You can't deny the possibility! That's why you all seized up with fear when that graduation rule was made clear to you! Am I wrong? So, I'm simply acting in accordance with what I think is best for me!
Just hold on.
Don't give a shit!
Hold on! Like hell I'm gonna let you run off and do whatever you want!
What?
Out of my way, Franken!
What?
What the fuck's that supposed to mean, huh?
Such ignorance.
One tiny bit of plankton drifting across the sea! So minuscule, so insignificant, they couldn't possibly have any kind of influence on the boundless ocean!
You're fucking dead!
I'm gonna kick your ass!
Stop it! We shouldn't fight!
What?
The fuck you just said? You're some kind of goody-goody little bitch, huh?
You wanna throw down?
What do you think you are, talking to me like that? You think you're my fucking dad or something?
Get on Mickey!
I am Mickey fucking Mouse!
No, I wasn't.
You son of a
fuck
bitch!
You!
Quam. He punched me. Mom! And I flew back in a heap. Mom, take me home. There's fighting going on. It was like something straight out of a comic book. I didn't even see the punch coming. It was just suddenly right there, in my face. One second I was standing there, the next I was soaring through the air. Now that I think about it, maybe I'd kind of forgotten. The kind of people I'd been trapped here with. My common sense had just stopped functioning. Being around all these ultimate had blown my fuses. So I guess I shouldn't be surprised it led to something as absurd as this. But I just lost track of that sense of reality. That was my last thought as my consciousness started to fade. Mom. I'm such a bitch, baby.
Mom!
Mom! Mom! Before it finally cut out completely. Mom, take me home, they're drinking beer! And when I finally opened my eyes again, what I saw was...
My son brought you here to protect you!
Where am I? As if it had become part of my daily routine. I woke up yet in another room I'd never seen before. I really need to stop taking those damn edibles. Okay, so... where am I now? Hey, look, it's stuff that we can skip. And I think we might want to leave that there.
Yeah,
let's save. We're going to probably leave that there. Yeah. So let's turn off Dang It Grandpa, turn back on the music, and start saying goodbye to some folks.
So, yeah. Thank you guys so much for coming. Thank you, Shrimp Sis, for playing the game while I make silly voices. we will... Yeah, sorry we could only do pretty much the prologue and only one small itty-bitty part of part one. But we're going to come back with this tomorrow and actually say some... we're actually gonna do a little bit more of chapter one tomorrow. Very early. Like, I will literally just go somewhere and come back and we will be back. Although, now... I don't know. It's pretty weird. Anyway, thank you all so much for anyone who stopped by, for anyone who like did anything for all the for the regimes, even though it might not look for anyone. So for anyone who followed off stream, let's see if there's someone we can raid. I doubt it. I mean, Merlene or Victoria. You know what? I'm gonna drop you by Victoria because he doesn't have a lot of people and he's playing Fall Guys. So that's always fun. Let's go raid Victoria. Shrimp raid. We're gonna be shrimp raid. If possible, just use an emoji of your liking. Let's do a simple heart. And let's see. Control C. Control V. Just do this. Copy this. And we will head off over to Victoria's chat and show him a lot of love and appreciation because, yeah, he works hard. Yeah, okay? We're going off now. I'm dropping you over to his pool.